Meantime, a local parliamentarian says while he welcomes the signing as a good first step for Grand Bahama, he remains cautious. He says a greater focus is needed to pull Grand Bahama out of the economic doldrums. Romeo Knowles picks up the story.
The public that this is the third heads of agreement that has been signed for the same hotel.
Sentiments from the Member of Parliament for Pine Ridge, Frederick McAlpine, who says he is content knowing that the government has signed an agreement for the purchase of the Grand Lucayan property. However, he says Grand Bahama has walked this road before.
I'm still wondering why the government is also doing a deal with an investor who also wants to do a deal in Nassau, because that was the same situation with the Wynn Group. And why should I want to fully invest in Grand Bahama when all the action, touristically and economically, is still in Nassau?
Back in August of 2018, the Pine Ridge MP stated that the government's purchase of the Grand Lucayan Hotel was a purchase gone wrong. Today, he says he wants to see a better plan put forward relating to the economic empowerment of the people of Grand Bahama.
We're very happy that something can and we hope would happen with this trip. The end all and be all can be on this trip. We're talking about thousands of people in Grand Bahama who have relocated to other parts of the Bahamas and even out of the country looking for jobs. And so it can't be all and end all on one trip. We need the government and the Port Authority to tell us what is the way forward for Grand Bahama economically.
McAlpine acknowledges that his comments may at times seem critical, but he says he wants to see better for Grand Bahama.
I want to know what we're doing. I want to know where we're going, because it seems like we're just drifting. Where are we going economically? Grand Bahama, and I'm not putting all of this on the shoulders of the government. I'm also asking the Port Authority, what role are they going to play in terms of seeking to take us down the path of vision? And where are we going? It's been 25, almost 30 years that we've been in this circle. And we need to see some progress. And yes, we thank the government, but again, show us the money.
Romeo Knowles, ZNS Network News.